to Tony Giovanni. Tony, I loved it when Ricky Morton took those glasses and stomped it.
Obviously, Ricky Morton of the Rock and Roll Express, even Robert Gibson, they're not going to be intimidated by the heavyweight champion of the world, David, but a lot going on here today in the world of wrestling.
That's right, because the cup is getting closer. And as that road gets shorter to New Orleans, it gets harder on a lot of wrestlers. There's a lot of pressure.
A lot of pressure. One man who has a lot of pressure is Ron Garvin, because many people feel that he is a man deserving of a title. And, of course, he has chased Ric Flair around for many months after that world heavyweight title. And today, Ron Garvin gets a chance to get that world TV title away from Arn Anderson, because we have re-signed.
That's a rematch.
I'll tell you what, not to interrupt you two illustrious gentlemen, but you know, you come out here on national television and waste the people's time talking about Ronnie Garvin, the man that is this much short of Ric Flair, this much short of Tully Blanchard, and of course, last week, 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, whatever it was, came this much short of beating Arn Anderson, and you want the rematch. Well, Ronnie Garvin is not what's happening in professional wrestling, so quit talking about him and Dusty Rhodes, because those two together are the top contenders for more belts, but they don't have nothing to show for their capabilities. Is my right or wrong?
Well, let's draw a little distinction here, because we have two types of individuals. We have chasers and we have catchers. This man over here is one of the catchers, as you can see, because he has the prize in his hand.
Killer instinct is what it is.
Mr. Garvin has a tendency to be a chaser, and I think he'll be a chaser all his life, because as Mr. Blanchard so eloquently put it, he's always this close to getting there, and I fail to see why he's going to be given another opportunity today on national television.
And we get to see another chaser in just a few minutes. But I tell you one thing, JJ, right here on national TV, the great job you've done, baby. Two round-trip tickets to Paris. Have a good week.
Hey. Right, a reward
right
there.
That's right.
Okay. You heard it. We have re-signed Ron Garvin, Arn Anderson for the World TV title. What's going on with Pistol Pez Wally? We'll talk about that and much more right here today. Let's go to the ring.
Because in the ring, Chief Wahoo McDaniels, the Big Chief, against Ray Traylor. This is a big man, Mr. Traylor, but he's against a hard chopper in Chief Wahoo McDaniels.
All right, Traylor, look at him, David. Going right to work on Wahoo, which was a big mistake.
Now he starts to chop him down his side. Jack Mayer takes him. Tony. J.J. Dillon, Tully Blanchard, trying to run down Ron Garvin. I think they're going to find out. The match coming up right here. Ron Garvin against Arn Anderson for the World Television title. It is going to be something. Parchop! Takes him down. We have gorgeous Jimmy Garvin with us. And you know Mr. Garvin is watching.
And finally, too, Magnum T.A. is here. Joe Nighthawk Coltrane in action. The Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez.
Also, Tony, what about this other match that's coming up? Oh, good job. The six-man tag team match. Pistol Pez Whatley, Baron Von Raschke, and the Barbarian, managed by Paul Jones. Look at that. Good move.
Great move by McDaniel.
And look, he picks him up. He's not finished with him yet.
Well, I tell you, he's been noted to have a big temper in wrestling.
Ooh, that's it. Now you can see that temper.
Obviously, Ray Traylor has really gotten his dander up.
He wants to chop him. Chop him right down to the mat. Catches him. Fist in the midsection. Traylor trying to keep him away. Wahoo goes right for the eyes. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. And Precious. I'm going to include you in on this, too. Watch Wahoo. Watch what he can do. He can destroy it. Individual. Wahoo McDaniels and Mark Youngblood. They're going to be vying for that Jim Crockett Sr. Memorial Cup and the $1 million in New Orleans.
And they're quite a tag team, Youngblood and McDaniel. Matter of fact, Mark Youngblood, Wahoo McDaniel, one time were the NWA World Tag Team Champions. So you know they're a fine team.
24 of the greatest teams in the world on the road to New Orleans. Well, who now? Dogs his prey. Gets the leg. Drives a knee into it. There you see the big man, Ray Traylor, trying to make it to the ropes. He's a tough Indian. Wahoo McDaniels. Ha-cha! Right to the chest. Backs him into the ropes. Here he goes. Flips him across. Chop! Cuts him right down. Now chop across the head. He goes over. Pins him. What a count. Your winner, Chief Wahoo McDaniels. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, you're in trouble. Sit right here. Cuts him down. Your winner, Chief Wahoo McDaniels.
Things are heating up around the world of professional wrestling, including this man right here, Magnum CA U.S. Champion.
Well, things are about as heated up with Nikita Koloff as I can stand, you know. I've had to listen to him come out here and talk for weeks and weeks, months on end, it seems to me. And I got a little bit tired of hearing all that talk, you know. Actions do speak a lot louder than words, Nikita. And you've been talking about what you would do when you get the opportunity. Well, I got an opportunity here just a little while ago when we've got a piece of VTR film. I want all the people out there to see it because this really expresses my true feelings toward Nikita Koloff, and I think the film will be self-explanatory.
Let's take a look at what he's talking about. This could be it. Freak out, and we have a freak out. And Ivan continues to pound away. Nikita with a shot. What's he doing? He's after the chain. He's got that wretched chain. And he's got a rip like a guy with a chain. Oh, no. Big. Nikita caught off the ring. Who's Magnum? Magnum T.O. into the ring. Drops him on Magnum. That's that chain. He loses the chain. Magnum's got a chain. Oh, look at Magnum. He's there. We've seen that scene before, Magna, but never with Nikita Koloff hanging over the ropes.
Well, Nikita Koloff, maybe now you know where I'm coming from. That chain fits around your neck just as good as it will mine. Now, Russian chain match, this is the thing you're supposed to be frightening me with, intimidating me with. Well, nothing is going to intimidate me. This is what it's all about. This is what's pushed this confrontation to a head. And if it's a Russian chain match, that's just fine. They make steel right here in the good old U.S. of A, too. And I can handle it just fine. Remember real well what it felt like when I choked up on that chain, because I'll never forget it. And I'll get the opportunity to do it again. Let's get it on.
All right, Magnum CA, we'll see Joe Nighthawk Coltrane and much more right after this.
Against Tony Zane.
And David, our first look at Nighthawk. He's talked to us a couple times here on World Championship Wrestling, but our first chance to see him in action. Certainly a powerful looking young man, isn't it?
Tony, I have seen him in action, in person. This guy is something. He is strong. Look at that right there. He knows how to use his strength. He can wrestle. Good arm drag. Comes up, has that arm bar, has it in tight.
You know, we talked to Nighthawk one time, and his concerns right now are with Tez Wally. And I think, you know, that's a subject that many people around the world of wrestling are talking about.
He said, you know, that he was his friend. He thought he knew him, but now I don't think anyone really does it, maybe except Paul Jones. All right, Zane comes up, tries to drop the elbow. Nighthawk moves out of the way, comes in, goes right back, picks him up, has him. All right, slam on the mat. All Has that arm again. Picks him up. Gets him ready. Has him. What an arm! Look at that! Look at that strength! Shoulder breaker! Has Zane down. Has him down with a shoulder breaker. Your winner, Joe Nighthawk Coltrane. I like it. Look at this. Tony, he has him with one arm. Take Zane and watch him. Drive it right down in the mat. Oh, look at that shoulder. Word. Your winner, Joe Nighthawk Coltrane.
This is him, the one, the only, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin with Precious.
Oh, I feel so good today, ladies and gentlemen. I want the whole world to know that. The gorgeous Jimmy feels great. I got some depressing news, though, for the people. I got some real bad, heavy news, so you might want to pay attention. You know, I really didn't think Wahoo McDaniel was going to answer my challenge, but I guess his pride got the better part of him, and he came off that reservation. Now I understand he's really looking for me. I found out, you know, last week he came out here messing with my squeeze when I was tied up, and that better not happen again, boy. That better not happen again. That's not the bad news, though. I've been getting in touch with a few people. I've been watching a few films, and Wahoo McDaniel is not the same, ladies and gentlemen. He's not the same. I've talked with the doctors, and I found out something. I found out. Let me look at your eyes, son. I found out, ladies and gentlemen, that Wahoo McDaniels has a dreaded disease called swamp fever, and I'm not going to wrestle him until he brings a note from his doctor. Now, I know you're saying, well, how do you know he's got swamp fever? Well, I asked the doctor, I said, Doc, are you sure you think Wahoo McDaniels has got swamp fever? And he says there's two ways to find out. If his nose is swelling up and getting real big and ugly, that's a sure sign. And if his hair's falling out, you better get yourself a shot, because the boy's got it, and Lord only knows, the guy's got a funny-looking nose and his hair's falling out. So I know he's got swamp fever. Now, I'm not going to get in the ring with somebody carrying some nasty disease. Spray the air, baby. I'm not getting in the ring with a guy that's sick. And Wahoo McDaniels, you're like a lame horse. And we all know what they do to them horses, don't we?
One, the only gorgeous Jimmy Garvin with Precious. More action when we come back.
So second fan, this great athlete, the Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez, will be going to the ring. Will he stop by to join us right here on World Championship Wrestling?
Toda la gente de San Antonio, el corazón va a venir para atrás. El 22 de mayo va a venir el toro.
The Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez. Now let's go to the ring.
And here he goes, the Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez. And he is that. This man is like a stick of dynamite, just waiting to explode. He and Jimmy Vaillant are going to be in New Orleans at the Cup. They're going to be some combination. Here they go across. Good tackle. Put that shoulder right into him. Leaps over. Comes back. Good drop kick. Taking that. Use the legs. The explosive power of the Raging Bull and Jimmy Vaillant together. That's going to be some combination. 24 of the greatest teams in the world are going to be there. And there's so many rounds that Tony is taking two sessions. There's one session at 2 o'clock, then the evening session.
That evening session will start at 7:30. Now, during that afternoon session, fans, you'll see such great tag teams in action as Magnum T.A. and Ron Garvin, the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette, and other great tag teams will be there.
Wahoo McDaniels, Mark Youngblood.
That's right.
The Sheep Herders.
The Raging Bull and Jimmy Vaillant will be in action. And you know, the Raging Bull and Jimmy Vaillant, they've been teaming up a long time, David. It's not like it's a brand new combination.
That's right. And when they go out there, they go out there to win. He doesn't mess around. Still has that leg. In this tournament, you cannot wrestle defensively because it ends in a draw, both teams are out. He still has that leg. Takes now, twists the other way. Backs up. Got the elbow right across it. Mayor, we're going to have that match. The world's television title. The Hands of Stone, Ron Garvin. Oh, he's going to take on the champion, the world television champion, Arn Anderson, in a rematch.
Getting a good look at Manny Fernandez just a moment ago. He's been known to have the most awesome backhand in wrestling. And he certainly was sitting Bob Owens down quickly. Now has him tied up, David.
What? Use the power of his legs to get out of it. Caught him right in the head.
There's that backhand.
Backing in the ropes. Here he goes. There's that backhand again, like you were talking about, Tony. Took Owens right down to the mat. Jumps up, catches him with a knee. Takes his time now. Knee right in the head. Backs him in. Here he goes. Good, hot backdrop. Puts him hard on the mat. Picks him up. Across. Fly burrito! Puts the man down. The raging bull hooks the leg and has him for the pin. Your winner, Manny Fernandez. Watch him now. A flying burrito by the raging bull. Manny Fernandez is your winner.
And we're ringside with Chief Wahoo McDaniel. I'm sure you may have heard the comments of gorgeous Jimmy impressions out here earlier.
Well, you know the man, and I'm in a good mood today because I could be very angry. But you know, he's going around telling me I got swamp fever and I have a big nose. Well, I've always had a big nose. You know, Garvin, I played 10 years of pro football and I had my nose broken 11 times. That could have something to do with it. But a man's nose and his hair has nothing to do with it, Garvin. As far as you see in my nose, we've had one encounter. A man slipped up behind me and hit me with a chair in the back of the head, so he tells everybody how tough he is. He tells everybody he wants to wrestle a legend. Well, I'm telling you, out of the goodness of my heart, Jimmy Garvin, I've signed the contract, and I'm going to wrestle you. And if you can beat me and back up everything you said for 3 months when I wasn't here to face you, then more power to you. You deserve to be at the top of the ladder. But I hate to say where you're going to be when I get through with you.
Chief Wahoo McDaniel with us on World Championship Wrestling and more right after this timeout. Program, Ron Garvin, a rematch for that World TV title against Arn Anderson, the champion.
Well, you know, first of all, I'm proud to be an American. I'm proud to be a professional wrestler. Professional wrestling has been my life. Of course, I'm still after Ric Flair. But there's a lot of other titles around, like the National Heavyweight title, the World Television title. And, you know, Arn Anderson has an open contract. I'm a hustler. I go out and hustle for what I want, for what I've got. So you can't lay down at home and think about, well, I want this, I want that. No, you got to go out and you got to do it, see? And every time there's a title on the line, there's an open contract that it's available for me to put my name on the dotted line, I'll be there. And Arn Anderson, you have an open contract, and you made a statement on TV, there is two kinds of people. People that have things and people that want things. Well, to have things, you've got to want them. You're looking at somebody that wants it bad, you see, and I'm going to do it. Now, the James Crockett Memorial Cup, the only thing I can say about it is Mangum T and I got it together. You know what I'm saying?
Yes,
we got it together as a team. Thank you.
All right, Ron Garvin, man with a hand of stone. Let's go to the ring.
In the ring, one part of the World Six-Man Tag Team Champions. Ivan Koloff, the commander. And listen to the fans, the chant of USA. Watch Ivan control. Gene Ligon. Back in the corner. Always outside. A man that refuses to wrestle on television until he gets the contract that he wants with Magnum TA. Drive that knee into the chest. There you see Nikita, the Russian nightmare. Watching and learning.
Yeah, seems to have recovered maybe a little bit from what happened at the hands of Magnum TA.
Gene quickly goes right after the leg. Spins around. Grabs again, spinning toe. Ivan trying to kick him off. Watch that, goes out. Watch out for Nikita. Snap that neck. Ivan goes out again. Here he tries to get back in. Ivan turns him around. Power fist across the chest. Then he drives the shoulder. Snaps his neck now. Headlock. In the ropes. Here they go across. Wisely takes him down. Goes after the leg again. Ties him up. Tony, like you said, that Russian chain fits neatly around the neck of Nikita Koloff. And the boss, Magnum TA, can put it to use the best way. Hang him high. Good Ivan, still favoring that leg. He's the ring general. Those Ligon out.
Well, innocent until proven guilty.
I don't trust him. He goes, gets right, fist in the back. Ligon goes after it, has that leg again. Puts it right into the post. Stays with it. Ivan. Hard right hand to the head.
Hey, one thing the Russians are noted for, and there was a case right there, they could take a lot of punishment, a lot of pain. Ivan had his leg wrapped around that post, came right back to knock Gene Ligon off his feet.
He goes. Still holding that leg.
He's
not working that well.
Goes up.
Takes Ligon, flips it across. Puts the elbow right in the midsection. Drops the other knee on the head. Backs up. Gets up on that second rope. Just waiting. That left leg is really bothering.
It really is. But still, being able to shrug the paint off and continue the assault on Gene Ligon.
Wouldn't this be something? Remember, the other Russian, Crusher Khrushchev, he's out because of leg injury.
How could the Russians, how would it be for them to respond in a wrestling match if they didn't have somebody else with them? You ever thought about that? I mean, it's always two or three running around together. And you're right. This is important for Ivan Koloff to win this match.
Yes, it is.
And not injure this leg anymore.
Goes to the pin. Ligon kicks out of it. But we have on our side the boss, United States Heavyweight Champion, Magnum TA. He'll take both men on if he has to. Here he goes, elbow! By Ivan. Goes down, hooks that leg. Ligon kicks out again. Now they argue about the count. Ligon blocks him. Catches him with a forearm, a good forearm. The driving in. Hot. Ivan moves out of the way just in time.
Ivan goes up. That second rope. Puts the elbow. Again, knocks the wind out.
Right below the rib cage is where that elbow hit.
Drops the leg across the chest. Still favoring that left leg, though. Begin trying to fight back. Ivan goes right for the eyes. Backs him in the ropes. Takes him down. That kicks him out. He's on the floor. Ivan's bothering the referee.
Watch out, Nikita! Uses that chain. Typical.
Gene Ligon certainly is not going to be able to get up from that, and if he does, he's not going to be the same in this match.
I think all of us would enjoy it to see Magnum take the chain, wrap it again and again around his neck, then hoist him up where his toes are dangling from the ground. Your winner there. Ivan Koloff with the help of Nikita. Look at them.
Well, it's obvious.
The proud.
You don't like.
I don't. The proud Russian Nikita Koloff and Ivan Koloff are your winners.
More action right after this. The NWA World Heavyweight title, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes and Baby Doll.
You know, Tony Schiavone, Nature Boy, Rick Flair, Dave, the number, Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, Power, the whole wrestling world throughout the universe is out of the Focus Theater in New Orleans, Louisiana, and the Nature Boy, Rick Flair. Whether he makes it there or not is not my concern. The thing is, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, will be there. Also in New Orleans, Louisiana tomorrow, you're going to have your opportunity, Arn Anderson, to try to get done what nobody's been done. Laid me out right there before, a minute of time, laid up, bad leg, bad ankle, still came back. Ole Anderson is yet to reappear on this television nationwide and make his statement about why he was laid out. Has yet to reappear. Charlie Blatt, you're running around the national heavyweight title, knowing that Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, holds all the cards. Nobody in the world, nobody in the country, nobody anywhere, any place, any time, anyhow, doesn't like the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Let me tell you something, Double A Line Anderson, remember that the Tower Pie Dusty Rhodes is here, walking with the most beautiful lady in the world. Every time we walk down that aisle, she looks so sweet. Marilyn Monroe up there in that great 100 grand in the sky, looked down and said, only one was made like me. And not since Marilyn Monroe has there been a beautiful woman like Baby Doll. Got that bosom just as beautiful as can be going down there. Like two great pyramids in Egypt, Jack. Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, is proud as punch. Double A Anderson, prepare yourself for a broken jaw, a broken leg, and a broken heart. Because broken hearts are dished out for Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. Daily, whether it be man, woman, or child, beast that crawls this earth, broken hearts are handed out by Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. Titles are dictated by Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. Ric Flair, Charlie Blanchard, and life is dictated by Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, because the American Dream lives in this country. I have no equal. I have only one thing, the greatest sports attraction in the country today, the greatest revenue producing revenue product of the Ted Turner Superstation throughout this country is Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. I like to tell my mama in Houston, Texas, and Dusty is no good today, and what's going to happen in New Orleans?
Well, I'll tell you what, Dusty. You know, you've got a lot of work to do in New Orleans the week before the tournament. We have a lot of first appearances to make. But I'll tell you what, I'm going to give you that week off. I will make all of your appearances for you. I will make them in grand style. And whenever you fly in that Saturday morning of the tournament, I will have our personal stretch limo waiting for your Learjet at the airport.
Hey,
for you.
In the words of the awesome Ric Flair.
American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, go to the ring.
Ay, Jalisco, Jalisco, Jalisco. Jalisco.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Carl Stiles against Hector Guerrero. Watch this young man. He is good. He is very good. Hector Guerrero is a fine athlete. What an entrance he made to the ring, David. Very powerful, but also very quick.
Yes. He and his brother are on the way, on the road to New Orleans.
Hector and Chavo Guerrero, you know, as you take a good look at Hector, they are former tag team champions from around the world. They have held many regional tag team titles, and so they're a fine team also. Get a good look at Hector here and his style of wrestling.
Good tackle. Drop down. Over. See how quick. Good drop kick. Backs him in the ropes. Switch now. Hector goes up. Arm drag takes him over. Just the sheer speed of this young man. Wears the opponent down. Has that arm bar. Him over, catches him again, holds on, comes up with that arm bar.
Out of Mexico City. Styles now, David. Yeah, did a good job getting out of that hold.
Styles takes it. Good elbow in the chest. Picks Hector up, has him. Slam backs in. Tries the elbow. Hector moves out of the way. Puts the head right into the turnbuckle. Bends him back. Hard right hand, right to the head. Here he goes.
Double forearm right to the forehead.
Has it exactly. Thought it.
Thought he had the pin there. And now he's at Styles up. Big man to slam here.
Oh, yes, he is. Shows you the strength of Hector Guerrero. What's he going to do now? Rolls him over. Puts that knee right into the small of the back. Now he takes him. Has him.
Now right there, much in the fashion of Ron Garvin, just tying the man up.
Oh, yes. Fighting. Styles biting him. Now he starts to pound away.
Good.
Grabs that leg. Oh, great. Yeah. Snaps it back. Uh-oh. He is going to take his leg off. Styles is trying to stop him, but Hector is going to put him exactly where he wants him.
Got a two count.
There it goes now. Styles, he is in pain. The big man. Styles goes right for the eyes.
You know, Styles has been able to do this during this match, been able to rake in the eyes or bite a finger to get out of some holds. But Guerrero keeps coming right at him every time.
Hard fist to the back of the neck. Hector takes him down. Now starts that pound away.
hard fist right into the chest.
Only got a two count. There's a warning from Pee Wee Anderson, the referee.
Wonder what he's worrying about.
The only thing that can happen here in a match, David, you never know when your temper's going to get the best of you.
Takes the leg now. Now he has Styles. Picks him up. Good suplex. Comes in. Uses the ropes. Comes off. Spins around in the air. Knocks the wind out of him.
Great match and a great win.
Watch Hector. Guerrero comes up. Now watch him spin. He goes up. Spins in midair. Comes down. Your winner, Hector Guerrero.
More action right after this, Tampa.
Gentlemen, we have six-man tag team action. Pistol Pez Wiley, Baron Von Raschke, and the Barbarian against Rocky Knuckles.
Bill Tebb and Brody Chase. And we're just waiting.
What a sight
for
this
Paul Jones.
Look here, David. I guess every man has his price. I guess the truth is out now.
There. Paul Jones bought someone. Look at Paul Jones. Look what.
Yeah, look at his attire.
Get two of them out of here right now.
I guess he is the general of the army. Now T.J. Khan is up there with him also.
Pistol Pez Wiley holding up that piece of hair that he cut from Jimmy Vance. Got all four of them. T.J. Khan, Baron Von Raschke, the Barbarian, and Pistol Pez Whatley. Rocky Knuckles starts the other team. Pez starts. Starts to pound away on the back. Pez, hard slam. Doesn't stop. Points his finger and then starts to pound away on the head. Makes the tag to the Baron. Baron Snapmare takes him out. Stacy Jones puts that lock of hair in his pocket. They said any way they can, they're going to get rid of Jimmy Vann.
That certainly is quite an army, yes.
Now, look at this monster, the Barbarian. Press him, bam! Oh, jumps in the air right on Tam. Backs him in, whips him across, catches him, put right in the chest. Catch him again. Headbutt. Takes Tab down. Picks him up. One arm. Huge arm.
And remember, that's a man we call Big Bill Tab. Everybody looks small against the Barbarian.
The Barbarian just throws Tab over and says, I want another one. I want to beat on another one. Give him to me. Puts him across. Drop kick. monster that can fly. Now, pistol pads come in. Sasu. Starts kicking him.
You know, Dave, I'm not so sure that the name pistol is so apropos anymore.
I am going to agree with you. You see Paul Jones looking around. I think he's watching, checking to see if Bane's around there.
He's biting in the face now. Heads biting in the face. Tony, we can't. I know T.J. Khan is always standing at the back of Paul Jones to protect him.
That's right. Right behind, a couple steps behind Paul Jones, T.J. Khan is Eugene Jones.
He's just, there you see. There's Khan right behind him. Watch out for Jones.
Takes that riding crop. Now the boots. Big black boots. Now Pez helps him too.
Look at Jones. Come on, Jones won't leave it to his men. What's wrong with him? He's going berserk.
Look, Barbarian.
Paul Jones, his greed and his wanting to be the most powerful man
has made him go completely nuts. Now Baron Von Raschke's in there. This army is something. High back drop. Starts to stomp away. Raschke has him. Snap mare. Kicks him over. Goes in. Breaks the fingernail right down his back. They tag the Bill Tab. Big Bill Tab.
Taylor, it's World Championship Wrestling. And certainly action here today. We have to take a short break.
We're coming in right back. Don't go away.
Bang! To the Barbarian. Barbarian headbutt. Takes Tab. Takes him with those big trees that he has for arms. Clotheslines him. Backs him in. Here he goes across.
Oh! Flying!
Shoulder block. Headbutts Tab. Pushes him across the ring with him. Paul Jones, Tony at some armory, T.J. Khan, Baron Von Raschke, the Barbarian, and now Pistol Pez Whatley. Barbarian drops him across, drops Big Bill Tab across the ropes. Barbarian takes him again. Here he goes. Whips him across. Puts the foot right into his chest. Pez slaps Tab. Look at Jones. Jones likes it. Then slap him. Slap him again and again. Make the tag.
Quite an army that Paul Jones.
I love it when Shotgun slaps him.
What did you call him? Say Shaska?
It sounded like it, or something close.
The Baron just working over Bill Tab now.
Here they go now. Now the Barbarian. They make that tag. Baron's back in. has him, whips him across. Hip toss. Takes him out, makes the tag to Pez. Pez is ready. What in the world is he doing? Headbutt.
A flying headbutt. Paul Jones is assembled army, including the Baron, the Barbarian, T.J. O'Conn, and the man he calls Sheska. And Watley.
Let's watch Sheska, our pistol feds. Come in. Get some momentum off the ropes and headbutt. Your winner, Paul Jones and his army.
The World TV Champion Don Anderson has a very, very tough title defense right here today.
Have you ever seen a nicer group of guys in your life? Probably not. On a serious note, Tony Giovanni, topic of discussion today, Ronnie Garvin, you come out here claiming to be a bad apple. Just a few short weeks ago, I gave you one chance at greatness right here on national television. Well, now I'm going to show you what kind of champion I profess to be, Tony Giovanni. I don't come out here and flap my yap just to hear myself talk. You understand, when I won this title, I told you I'd be the greatest world television champion in history. I would come out here on national television, do what no champion has ever done, put my reputation, put my meal ticket on the line, week in, week out. Have I done that?
Yes, you have.
Against top contenders. Dusty Rhodes never did it. Everybody claims, well, you never beat Dusty for this title. This is mine, Rhodes. Don't put any claim to it because I've paid the price. This is mine. I've earned it. And if you want to take a good look at this face, take a good look at this face. I earn it every night. I fight them all. Right from Wahoo McDaniels, Magnum, Manny Fernandez, right down to you, Dusty. You take a good look at this face. Ain't nothing pretty about me, but the fact is I'm an Anderson. It's inbred into me. I can't help being the fact that I am a man full of pride and guts. So, Ronnie Garvin, you want another shot right here on national television? I'm going to give you a second. Shut your mouth. I'm going to give you one more shot at greatness. But when it's all said and done, I want all these people to shut up. I want everybody in this country of ours to realize I am the world television champion. I'm going to be the world television champion until I see fit to relinquish it. And once again, it's been your pleasure.
Don't go away. More action when we come back. Joe Freaks in the studio audience can put me out of my good mood. I told everybody that I was going to be manager of the year, and I was. I told everybody that the Midnight Express were going to be world tag team champions, and they were. I told everybody that Denny Crum was going to lead the University of Louisville Cardinals all the way to the top, the pinnacle of the NCAA championship, and the prophecy came to pass. He did, and now I'm saying like I have been that the Midnight Express and Jim Cornette are going to the top in that Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup Tag Team Tournament. And Tony, if we win this one, they're going to burn me at the stake for being a witch, because I got supernatural powers. I know what's going on. I can foretell fortunes. And let me tell a couple of fortunes while I'm at it. Road Warrior, your future is looking very, very dim. You know all the letters we get to World Championship Wrestling. The only match that the people want to see more than the Rock and Roll Express, the Midnight Express, is the Road Warriors and the Midnight Express, because Road Warriors been running all around mouthing off. The people think they're unbeatable. The people think they're the ones that can take the Midnight Express. Well, let me tell you something, Road Warriors. I hate to be the one to pop your bubble, but the Rock and Roll Express were unbeatable until we beat them. And you've been unbeatable so far, but we're going to clean your clock. The match is going to take place. And you know, I understand, I have it on good authority. The Russians got a hold of your brain, Paul Ellering up there in Baltimore, Maryland, and they fixed him up real good. I think he's out of the picture for once and for all. So Road Warriors, that leaves you without a brain, because let me tell you something, Tony, if brains were gasoline, the Road Warriors couldn't propel a fleas motorcycle around a raindrop. They're stupid. You can put all that paint on, all that leather on, and all those spikes on, but until you got those World Tag Team Championship belts around your waist, Road Warriors, you're just another couple of muscle-bound clowns that look like the board of directors of a massage parlor someplace, wandering around the street without a title, without nothing. The Midnight Express can take you. I promise you that, because you may be big and strong,
But the Midnight Express are lean, mean, slick, quick, and a whole lot sneakier, Road Warriors. And we are going to destroy the legend once and for all. And then, the Rock and Roll Express, they still want... Wait a minute. They still want to get our belts back. What is that? What?
Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson. And watch them go. Cross into the ropes. Good tackle. Comes in, leaps over. Switch. Backslide. Has him down. Just about. Arm drag. Pitch him over. Quickly makes the tag. Comes in. Arm drag. Over. Ricky Morton, Robert Gibson there, fired up. They're going to New Orleans. Plus, good! Knee lift! Ricky Morton is especially excited about what he did to Ric Flair, the World Heavyweight Champion. Here they go. Good drop! Put it right through him. Diving leap to get out of that ring.
They certainly are geared up for that tournament. And speaking of the tournament, as we announced before, I want to remind the fans, because of Ted DiBiase, one of the teams entered and looking really strong, I understand, is Dr. Death Steve Williams and his partner Terry Taylor.
That's right.
Still the number 10 seed in this tournament. We understand that team is in top form and ready to go for the tag team tournament and the Super Bowl.
24 of the best in the world. Going to New Orleans. And they're all getting ready in there. Watch this. Oh. Yank that neck back. They don't want to peak too soon. Quite a few of the teams are going down early to get used to the building and the weather down there. They want to get a feel for the atmosphere of New Orleans and the Super Bowl.
I don't know how the weather's going to be prior to the 19th, but the 19th is going to be hot.
Oh, you better believe it.
Hot as a firecracker.
All day long.
And you know, the Rock and Roll Express right now, as we take a good look at Robert Gibson. They and Ricky Morton obviously still feeling the effects of that broken hand he received at the hands of the Midnight Express. Well, they're in top form right now.
Yes, they are. But remember, you know, like I said before, they don't want to peak too early. Because when you have the greatest teams in the world going after that cup, just can't do it. Plus, they're thinking about the Midnight Express. And Tony, they can meet them. They can meet them in a thing. And two, the way the Express are going to, they could peak too early. And they could, it's just possible, the Midnight Express could end up going to the Cup, not being the World Tag Team Champion. It could happen. The pressure is on. It is going to be something. Two sessions. Because there's so many matches. Here goes Ricky Morton. Up on that. Up on the ropes. Dives off. Right on the leg. Hard right hand.
Oh.
What's he going to do? Watch Robert Gibson now. He has that leg. They make the tag. Ricky comes right back in. Double team. Rolls out.
Here it comes. Here it comes. They are set. Double drop kick. Puts him down.
They got it. They have got it together. The Rock and Roll Express, they are the tag team of the 80s.
And fans, who do you think is going to win the cup and the $1 million? A lot of fans across the country think it's this team right here.
That's right. We'll find out. The 19th. The Rock and Roll Express are your winners.
Don't you dare go away.
The Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup, the most prestigious event of the year. Now Eastern Airlines has become the official airline of the Cup. Eastern is offering a 50% discount on round-trip airfare anywhere in the continental USA for New Orleans. Call 1-800-468-7022. Caller must request EZ4CP48. Call 1-800-468-7022. And remember, caller must request EZ4CP48. And fans, don't forget the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup coming to New Orleans, a gigantic one-day tag team tournament for $1 million and the prestigious cup. Also on this gigantic card, a match for the North American heavyweight title, no disqualification as the champion Hacksaw Jim Duggan defends against Dick Slater. And of course, for the NWA World Heavyweight title, Nature Boy Ric Flair, the champion, will defend against the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. For tickets, call Ticketmaster, 1-800-535-5151.
And a great tag team match we just saw from these two men, Robert and Ricky, the Rock and Roll Express. Not only that, last week on the program, two men do not back down to Ric Flair.
That's right, Paul. You know, the day is getting closer at Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. Plus $1 million. Me and Ricky have been training very hard. We've been going over a lot of tapes, studying all these teams that are going to be in the tournament. You know, for $1 million, that's going to put a lot out in everybody right there. Me and brother, Rock and Roll is here to stay. We're trying to do one thing, Tony. Walking away with $1 million in that nice big trophy.
That's right, Tony. One thing for Jimmy Cornette, brother. Let me tell you, Rock and Roll ain't never gonna die. We're gonna be on your back, brother, to put those belts back around our waist. Now again, Tony, we gotta say something about Mr. Ric Flair. You know, my hat's off to the gentleman because he has beat every professional wrestler there is today, because he is still the world's heavyweight champion. But one thing, Ric Flair, you come out here and you put us down, and as you see the tape right here, one whack, Tony, I knocked him, pulled off his feet. He goes, here we go. He wants to fight. I give him something to fight about. You know, there's not too much I can do about him jumping on me, but there's a lot I can do to get him off, as you can see right here. He might be right here. There you go, right there, Mr. Ric Flair.
Obviously, Ricky, he was not expecting you to do this to him.
Look at the fear in his eyes here, Tony, because he didn't know. He didn't know what he got a hold of right here. I told you right here, Ric Flair, don't you ever put your hands on me again. And as you can see, he did. Now, every goal in professional wrestling is to be a world's champion, no matter if it's tag team or no matter if it's single. But for one or another reason, is down there, Ric Flair. I'm at the top of the charts, right where you are. You might have a belt around your waist, but I'm up there beside you. Now, this right here is for all these nice people out here and for myself. Because, brother, when you step in the ring with Rick Morton, you're going to know one thing, that you've been in one hell of a fight.
New Orleans, we're getting ready.
All right. They are right. Let's go to the ring.
And we are ready for the United States heavyweight champion, Magnum T.A. The Boss. Good hip toss. Takes Mr. Mulkey, puts him in. Back drop. Hard on the mat. Nikita Koloff. Think about it. Belly to belly. Down on the mat. One, two, three. and that would be the end of you. The winner, United States Heavyweight Champion, with this, the belly to belly, Magnum TA, the boss, is your winner.
More action right after this time.
Like this, and I know one thing, Dusty. I know that Arn Anderson can be bought, and you may never make the tournament. My army is going to march through New Orleans, and when we get to the other side, we're going to have the cup with us. Now my army is complete. I am ready for 1986 war, and the war is on Jimmy Valiant. I have Baron von Reske. I have T.J. Codd and the Barbarian. And you people see something that was planned from the mastermind, me. When right here, the man that you know as Pistol Pez Whatley, the new addition, the man that infiltrated Jimmy Valiant's camp, I know everything that he has planned. I know one master plan he has that I won't even mention because it's so far out, so far ridiculous. It's a bunch of baloney. And now, here's the man right here, the new Shaska that completes the army.
What have I got here? Look at here! Look at here! It's a winning ass! And it's Jimmy Valiant's horse here! Let me tell you something, Jimmy Valiant. You is a low-down, dirty yellow dog, just like this hair's yellow. And tell you, just like it was, we got some more tricks for you in 86 with the Eight Rifles. And another thing I want you to understand, Boogie Woogie, if you think the war is over, you got another thing coming. The war has just begun. Let me tell you something, Jimmy Valiant. Who's zooming who, sucker? Shut up, Tony Zavante. You ain't had nothing to say. All you hillbillies out there, get ready. The ball's right here. Is it going to get you? And I'm going to tell you another thing. You Nighthawks, keep talking that stuff. You ain't nothing but a walk-up Tom anyway. And everybody knows it. From now to me, you are UT. I'm going to tell you what. Jimmy Valiant, ain't nothing I hate worse than a black Uncle Tom. It's a white Uncle Tom. And that's what you is, a white Uncle Tom. Jimmy Valiant. I said it, I command it, and it shall be done in 1986. Woo! Because the army is complete, and we're moving forward!
That's quite a crew. Now, time for our World TV title match.
We are set and ready. This match for the world television title, the challenger, the Hands of Stone, Ron Garvin, the champion, Arn Anderson, and they have started. Arn blocking it. He's losing control. He's lost it. Arn Anderson gets out of the ring. Remember, time is on his side.
Sure is.
Garvin has to be the aggressor. Garvin has that leg. He's gonna do. All Arn Anderson has to do is hold on, because Garvin has to beat him.
David, you're right. Arn Anderson does not have to beat Ron Garvin. Ron Garvin's got to beat Arn Anderson to win this title.
That is correct. But can Arn Anderson control Mr. Garvin? He's almost lost it before against him. What's going to happen? Does he have his number? Can Garvin do it? Just about. Arn complaining. Pulls the hair. Garvin goes back in. Now Garvin starts to pull. Both men, two of the best in the world. We're watching the very best right here on World Championship Wrestling. Garvin now starts the power. Just about has it there. Can he do it? Both men straining. Keep the advantage. Garvin, good trip. Takes him down. Control. Iron pulls the hair. Comes over the arm bar. Garvin still trying to get out of that. Good move to get up. Garvin takes him back down.
David, I think it's obvious. Fans watching at home can tell we are watching two men who can wrestle. We know all the moves. So far, it's been just complete wrestling action.
All right. Iron goes out of the ring. Garvin goes right after him. He knows he can't let him stall. Garvin has that leg. Has him. Take him now. Catch him. Right hand. Stuns him.
David, this is why, if fans don't understand the seating, this is why Magnum and Ron Garvin are seated number two. Ron Garvin is an offensive wrestler. He chased Arn Anderson right out of the ring, right back into the ring. He keeps the fight right to him. And that's why they are a high seed in that tournament.
Just like Ron Garvin said at the top of the program, anything he wants, he goes out and gets it. He doesn't talk about it. He does it. Here we go. He starts to tie him up. Mr. Anderson is going to look like a pretzel. What can he do? Hard fist right to the chest. Elbow to the top of the head. Now they start to slug it out. Back and forth.
Oh, you're playing in Ron Garvin.
Hard right hand to the head. Put him down.
You are playing in his backyard. What do you want to slug it out with him? That's his strong suit.
What'd he do? Iron rolls out. Again, he lost control. Stalling for time. Garvin just waiting. Remember, you have to beat the champion, Arn Anderson. He doesn't have to beat you.
That's right, David. Walking around on the floor is his advantage.
Yes.
What the heck? I mean, if the time runs out, he's still the champion. That's the way he'll approach it, I'm sure, if it gets too hard for him. Think all the fans realize, you on at home watching on television realize what happened there. Took him down by the tights.
Anderson is holding on for dear life, trying to slow Garvin down. Anderson's concentrating so hard on controlling. Wait a minute, Garvin comes right out of it.
Okay, if this match would happen to end during this break, we would show you what happened on instant replay. If not, we'll have more of this match.
Garvin just about has him
right after this timeout.
See, you have Tully Blanchard with you.
Tully comes out here wanting to be...
Come on, Tully!
commentate with us on this match, Tully.
I tell you what, give you just a little bit of expert advice. Arn Anderson, the world television champion, a normal man would be quit, give up, say I quit, anything else. But Arn Anderson out there still going strong, and now he's taking it to Garvin. Look at that tremendously legal fist that you always see Garvin using. But you know, that's got to hurt the ribs right there. But you see Arn Anderson always getting up. That's why he's the world television champion.
Like we said before, Arn Anderson does not have to beat Ron Garvin.
Kick out right there. Kick out.
Okay, James J. Dillon out here with us also now.
Garvin, the people's favorite, just like Dusty Rhodes Magnum. And you see scratching, clawing, pulling a guy's nose. All those legal things that you see by the fans' favorite. Now you tell me where the fans are at.
Garvin certainly is working Anderson over, David.
That he is.
Show cheaters never win.
Hard suplex, has him down.
Flair and myself are the champion and carry all the hardware. Get up, Double A, let's go to me.
Garvin goes over. Has him now. Shoulder by Arn Anderson.
Good move.
Garvin down.
Offensive move. Let's go, Double A. Let's go, baby.
Typical Anderson. He's taken everything that Garvin could dish out. Now Garvin's a little arm weary, like a boxer about that ninth round.
Come on, Double A.
His hands get a little heavy. And Arn Anderson's still in there in the thick of it. And he's turned the tide of battle around.
Get him, baby. Get him.
All right. Anderson definitely in control right now, David. But look at Garvin.
The true champion that you two have neglected to say, Arn Anderson took the man and took him down 3 weeks ago on national television. But being the true champion is right here giving him another shot on national television to show why Ronnie Garvin is just a little bit short of what it takes to really get the job done.
I don't know if we've ever slighted his ability as champion or not, David.
Come on, Double A.
No, we haven't.
Arn's ability, Blanchard's ability, Flair, all of them. They are certainly capable.
There's a choke, a blatant choke right in front of the referee.
We can't slight the ability of Ron Garvin right now to put that fist through the chest.
Ability, but he does like to break the rules of professional wrestling.
Oh, tell us about it, Tully.
Big right hands now. Those are open-handed slaps right there, and those are legal.
Good backdrop. Heads into fight. He's got it.
This is
it. He's got it ready.
This is his move right here. This is his.
Oh, good night. He's got him.
good defensive move. I'm sure wherever Ole Anderson is right at this moment up in Minnesota, he's very proud of how Arn Anderson is holding up the Anderson family tradition here today, a fighting champion.
Again, time is on Arn Anderson's side.
We saw very briefly Tully Blanchard in the background. He and James J. Dillon are right here at our ringside location watching this World TV title match and also helping us commentate and shouting words of encouragement to Arn Anderson, who's Tully's partner for the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup coming up.
All right, they're both in there. They're in the ropes now.
I think this also indicates the caliber of competition. The NWA, we're only 2 weeks away from the Cup, and here's two members of two of the top 10 seeded teams right in the thick of a very important match less than 2 weeks before the Cup.
Get out the way!
An injury in this match could cost somebody $1 million.
Everybody sees every week how bad Garvin beats up everybody and takes him with that big fist. But I tell you what, you see how Double A has taken everything and giving it all back.
Okay, Arn Anderson in some big trouble right here now. Arn Anderson's in big trouble. Tully! Tully, we got Ron! Okay, that's it. There's been a disqualification because of Blanchard running in, David.
Tully's putting a boost to him. What are they going to do to him?
It's that double gourd buster. Oh, no!
What are they going to do? They're trying to position him for something.
Ron Garvin's out. Look at him.
They're trying to position him.
They got... Look, what are they going to...
Oh!
He injured his boot!
On that right
hand!
Well, Arn Anderson...
Anderson is still the world TV champion.
Down there! You want some to take on Double A and myself? Garvin, you're not going to be using that illegal fist ever again! Ever again! You saw to it! We saw to it! The Fist of Stone is out of commission forever! Simple as 1, 2, 3. There's your team for the cups.
Yeah, well, it was a team that ended that. We're coming right back.
And look at this. There you see J.J. and Iron drag him over. Ron Garvin limp. They take that hand. They put it up against that steel post, dragging him over. They get him ready. Tully Blanchard takes his boot off, and now he starts to work. Pounding away on the hand. And again, trying to injure it. Your winner, Arn Anderson, and still world television champion.
And we're having more coming up right after this.
Go ahead, Tony. Say whatever you want to say. That's good enough. That's good enough. What about them University of Louisville Cardinals, huh? My hometown team, Denny Crum, led them all the way to the top, the NCAA champions, greatest in college basketball. And now that's inspired me to go out and lead my men, the Midnight Express, on to victory in that Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup tournament. And I'm looking so forward to it. And Rock and Roll Express, you want those belts back real bad, and it's getting desperate because it's almost time for that tournament, and you want to go in there as champions. Well, let me tell you something, punks. You will never get the World Tag Team Championship back from the Midnight Express because we're your worst nightmare. We're what you dread. We are what you loathe to get in the ring with because we're the mirror image of you. We're the dark to your light. We're the bad to your good. We're the opposite of everything that you stand for. When you get in the ring with the Midnight Express, it's just like wrestling the dark side of yourself, and that's something you're never going to be able to overcome, Rock and Roll. So do whatever you think that you can. But I promise you this. The Midnight Express are the World Tag Team Champions for once and for all. That includes the Road Warriors. That includes America's team. That includes anybody else in that tournament. You know there's a lot of tough teams. The Fantastics, Bobby Fulton and Tommy Rogers. Everybody knows down in Texas the kind of things that went on between us and them. The Fabulous ones, Steve Kern and Stan Lane, they're in the tournament. A lot of people in Tennessee remember a couple of matches between the Midnight Express and the Fabulous ones. All kind of teams. Speaking of Tennessee, Billy Superstar Dundee, Nature Boy Buddy Landell, Magnum T.A. and Ronnie Garvin, the most offensive team in professional wrestling. But I don't care who it is, because the Midnight Express is the greatest, and we're going to come out $1 million richer, and we're going to come out with that cup. Ladies and gentlemen, I present the team that has struck fear in the hearts of more men than Boris Karloff and Bela Lugosi. Liverboy Dennison, beautiful Bobby, the Midnight Express.
Team champion, Midnight Express.
David, we have an important announcement to make right here before Jim Cornette walks over. For you fans planning to come here at the studios of WTBS on Saturday, April the 19th, who have made reservations to see us tape that day, we will not be taping that day.
That's correct.
Those people who have reservations for April 19th, please come here on Sunday, April 13th, because we will tape on Sunday, April the 13th for you fans who plan to come on the 19th. Remember that.
Now. And everybody that wants to see me and the greatest team of wrestling can come on down there. Look at Denny Brown, World Junior Heavyweight Champion. Can't say a couple of good things about him, but he's hopelessly outclassed against the Midnight Express. You know something, Tony? First of all, David, I've been listening to you the past several weeks. Some of the ways that you describe people when they get to predicament, what do you belong to, the Marcus DeSade fan club or what, huh? You have got to be, what kind of magazines does he read? Do you have any idea? Okay, let me just say one thing. You know, the University of Louisville Cardinals, like I was talking about, has inspired me to win the tournament with the Midnight Express, the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. But you know, there's a lot of great sports events coming from Louisville, Kentucky, and one of them is the Kentucky Derby. Every year, The Kentucky Colonels, they have a big barbecue along about the time of the Derby, and they usually have Bob Hope or Frank Sinatra or somebody come. Beautiful, Dennis. They usually have Bob Hope, Frank Sinatra, somebody like that come down and speak. Colonel Sanders, well, he kicked the bucket a while back. But this year, my mother's going to pull a few strings. And believe me, my mother can pull more strings than Harpo Marx. And she is going to get me and the Midnight Express to be the guest of honor at that Kentucky Colonel's Barbecue so we can tell everybody how great we are after we won that $1 million and that Jim Crockett Senior Cup. And Tony, if you're real nice to me, then next week I may just bring you an official Kentucky Colonel's membership card so you can be a Kentucky Colonel and be part of the creme de la creme of Southern society. David, well, maybe the Mickey Mouse Club is still in operation. I don't know.
Dusty loved him.
You know, David, I'm gonna say this. Louisville Cardinals could lose some fan support. But one thing that's not gonna be lost here today is the ability of the Midnight Express.
They are good. Beautiful Bobby, look at him. Hard suplex. Mike Simonti. Now, Hoverboy Dennis comes in. Take a chance to say hello to... Wait, watch this. What's going on here now? They're starting it again.
Beautiful Bobby Eaton.
Here we go.
Dragging Mike Simonti on over.
Hold up here, baby. Hold it up.
Come on.
I'll give him a high five. Hold
up. Oh, my.
Did you see that guy, Mike Simonti? He almost fell on me. That's the clumsiest guy I ever seen in my life. Bobby was just trying to congratulate him for being a great wrestler, giving him a high five there. By the way, do you wash your hands before you come out here, David? I don't allow my men to come in contact with any unsavory elements.
Oh, I'm going to get him. But the one thing, like you said, you cannot deny, the Midnight Express, they are the World Tag Team Champions. They're good. But can they keep it? There are so many good teams out there fighting for that championship. The number one tag team championship in the world. Watch Bobby. He goes up, he gets ready, and he puts that knee right between the shoulder blades. Now, Loverboy Dennis. Oh, he's going to put his face right through the mat. Look at him. No way. Protect yourself or catch it. Stretches those arms back. Your winners, the World Tag Team Champions, the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette. Watch this now. Loverboy Dennis takes Simonti. There is no way to protect him. And puts his face right through the mat. Your winners, the World Tag Team Champions, the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette.
Ivan and Nikita Koloff with the World Six-Man Tag Team Trophy. We saw earlier a videotape of Magnum T.A.
You saw Magnum T.A.
with the chain.
Yeah, he come on attacking Nikita, and now you bad Magnum T.A. Or you bad in your mind for knowing your heart. Nikita bad in a heart. You put the chain around Nikita's neck. Who make it the end? Maybe you take a look at Nikita's neck, huh? You think you're going to hurt? You think you're going to hurt? Take a look at Nikita's neck. 22 inch neck. You think a chain is going to hurt? Maybe you get the chain and saw. You want to hurt Nikita. Meyadin, Diyadin. We saw the Mega T.A.
You see, Magnum T.A., we know now why you go on the offensive, why you attack Nephew Nikita, why you hang him with the Dote. You tried to injure him. so you could save United States heavyweight title. But you see, nephew Nikita is too strong, too well conditioned. You cannot hurt him, and it's too late for you. Contract is signed. Whenever your wrist is locked to one end of chain, nephew Nikita at the other end, and he starts beating on you, destroying you, injuring you, and then grabbing you by the wrist, dragging you around the ring, touching all four corners consecutively, to humiliate you and to gain victory, but most of all, to injure you, so the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup Tag Team Tournament, your team will not be able to enter. Just like you, Road Warriors. Yes, whether it's chain or whether it's cage match or six-man tag team, you will not be in tournament either. I can just see Jim Crockett Tournament Cup alongside the six-man tag team cup.
We have to go, and we'll see you next week on World Championship Wrestling.
I've got more to say.